Okay, let's do some more DFA practice. So here we have to show that these languages are regular and we have 6 languages to tackle. So the alphabet here is 0, 1. So the first one says sigma star. Well, remember that the star of something is 0 or more from that something. So this is same. Is the same thing as 0, 1, star. Well, that means that we have to pick 0 or more characters from this set. Well, this is the set of all binary strings. And for that reason, we can make a really simple DFA that accepts every string because the input alphabet is 0 and 1. So, our DFA then is quite simple. We have a start state, and it has to be an accept state because the empty string's always in the star of any language. And here, we can just self loop on 0 and 1. Cool, that was pretty easy. Now let's go over to the second one, which says we want the set with the empty string as the element of that set. So that means we have to accept the empty string. So let's make a really simple DFA that accepts the empty string. But notice that there is no other string inside this language other than the empty string. So that means we can't accept any other string other than the empty string. So the transitions on 0 and 1 can't stay here. They have to go to another state that is not accepting. I'm gonna call that state Q1. And once we're here, well, we should never accept because we've already read a character to get there. So we just stay there on 0 and 1. Now let's look on to the third one. This is the empty set. And a lot of my students would say, oh, well, that's just the same thing as this, because it's both empty. It's not true. This set has 0 things in it, no strings at all inside this one, whereas this one has a string on the inside. This one says that the DFA cannot accept anything. So it's basically just the opposite of this DFA that we made a little bit earlier. So let's make a small DFA where it doesn't accept any string. Okay, let's move on to this one. So this says every string, so sigma star is every string, minus, so take away, the empty string. So in English, this just says every string but the empty string. But we kind of solve the empty string problem here. So whenever you're making a DFA, always try to form it in terms of other DFAs you've already made. So this language has every string not in this one. So in order to make a DFA for here, remember, if we flip the final and non-final states of a DFA, then we can get the complement language. Well, is this the complement language? Well, this is every string but the empty string, and this one is the empty string. So in fact, we can make exactly the same DFA, but flip the non-final and final states. Just like this. Cool. So now let's move on to question 5. So this is the empty set star. Well, what is that? So remember, it's always 0 or more of something from this set. Well, based on what we saw from here, there's nothing inside the empty set. So you may think, well, this is just equal to the empty set because you're just picking nothing out of the empty set. But that's not quite true. What string is always in the empty set of any language? We saw before that, what is in the star of any language? Well, it's the empty string. Well, if we try to concatenate one or more of anything from the empty set, we're going to get the empty set. So it is not equal to the empty set, is equal to the empty string. And I think we made a DFA for that one already. So this one is exactly the same thing as that other DFA. Cool. So now let's move on to the final question. It says, is the set containing the empty string star? Well, let's see. Well, the empty string is in the star of any language. So let's write out what this set is. So it's the empty string that's always in there because we're starring it. Then we can pick one thing from the language and put it in. Well, if we pick the empty string, and that's what we get. So we get the empty string here. And then if we pick two things from the language and put them together, well, that's just going to be empty string twice. Well, if you concatenate the empty string with itself, you get the empty string. Well, isn't that what we already have? So in fact, this language is just the empty string, which is kind of interesting that we have exactly the same answer, even though we starred a different language. So in fact, this one, we can also make a really simple DFA for. And those are just some basic questions about DFAs.